So I'm getting a little bit more yellow, and I'm going to lighten that up one more time. Then I'm going to go to what's called a kicker color, or a contrasting color. Just because the paint is real thick like that doesn't mean it's no good. It just means it requires a little bit more paletting, a little bit more thinning. I'm thinning with mineral spirits. No fancy reducers, no fancy hardeners. Keep it simple. But we just build a simple design and build out from it. Add a little bit of weight where it's needed. That's not a brush here, by the way. Brush, the more it loosens up. But you see how I'm just using the tip. Rinse the brush in lacquer thinner, which will also clean it right up to the ferrule, so you get all the paint right out of the ferrule. And this is a green that it's called emerald green. And was using this yesterday because we're doing a restoration to Von Dutch's bus. And most of the inside of the bus is striped in this emerald green and brilliant blue. Most of the interior of the bus is kind of a deep teal. Now this color is going to have a tremendous amount of contrast. I'm just building this is a quick design. I'm just going to add some color. Kind of a wraparound design. Don't try this with a Mac. It'll just frustrate you. Just lay the tip down. Wow. You can see how the grid helps, and that tool that we've made still eliminates the time spent. When I did grids with a ruler, it would take me 15 minutes sometimes, because you got to measure each line and make it perfect, and the grid does that for you. Retails for $12. It's not an expensive piece, but it'll sure add to your symmetry. And you can pick up one of my DVDs and it'll show you a different technique. This is a finished piece. I'm just going to put my signature on it with the tip of the brush only. And I'm going to take a break and come back, and I'm going to show you old school pinstriping with the same brush. That's it.